Assalamu alaikum and good morning. Students, I hope all of you are doing well. It's biology for class 10. And today I am going to explain you about the control and coordination in plants. This chapter is not going to come in your final exam, but it is a very important chapter for your future classes. So briefly I'm explaining you this chapter, and already we have completed the control and coordination in human being, that is nervous system. In plants there are no nervous system, there is no nervous system is there. Here in the plants, the control of the plant part or the development of the plant part is controlled by the hormones. Now, what are hormones? Hormones are the specific chemicals. The chemicals which are secreted by the different glands in the human being, but in the plants, almost all the parts of the plants are having the hormone. They produce the hormone. And they are the specific chemicals which are responsible for the growth and development of the plant parts. And these hormones are also known as phytohormones. So definition of plant hormones or phytohormones. Plant hormones or the phytohormones are specific chemical compounds which are responsible for the growth and development of the different parts of the plant. Okay. And these plant hormones are present in very low concentration in the plants. The hormones are auxins, gibberellins, cytokinins, abscisic acids, and ethylene. Clear? These are the five plant hormones. You can see over here the plant hormones or the phytohormones. Now we can divide these hormones in the two categories. The hormones which are responsible for the growth which promote the growth of the plant parts, and the hormones which are responsible for the inhibit the plant growth. Look student, why it is necessary? You have observed the plants around you. Okay, the plants are growing, you can see the height also, so long, so many meter high also the plants are there. So they are the specific hormones which control the growth of the plant, and these hormones are called plant growth inhibitors. Understood? So the hormones, the five hormones can be divided again to the two categories, plant growth promoters and plant growth inhibitors. The growth promoters plants are auxins, gibberellins and cytokinins. And the plant growth inhibitors are abscisic acid and ethylene. Clear students? Now the next. What are the uses of this plant hormone? The first one is abscisic acid. Okay. What which category abscisic acid is coming? It is coming in the category of the plant growth inhibitor. Clear? And that's they are responsible for the closing of stomata. Like it is a very normal phenomena in the plant, opening and closing of the stomata. But here also one hormone is responsible for that, that is abscisic acid. So abscisic acid make the plant, means the it is responsible for the closing of stomata. And then it is responsible for the seed dormancy. Now the term dormancy is a new term for you. What is the mean by dormancy? Dormancy is a stage of the plant, means in the seeds, where they can remain. Till then they are not having the favorable condition. They can remain alive. Okay. The condition in which they are not germinating. So the abscisic acid are promoting the seed dormancy. You can see the seeds are remaining in your kitchen also, in the jars. Many plant seeds are there, but they are not germinating. So which hormone is responsible for that? That is abscisic acid. Understood? Then second one is coming, that is auxins. Auxin is a hormone which is a growth hormone. It helps in the cell elongation and differentiation, means the elongation of the cell, and then in which tissue it will be converted. The differentiation is a responsibility of the auxin, and it is helping in the shoot and roots elongation. Okay, the height of the shoot is increasing due to the auxins. The it is a growth promoter hormone. Next is coming, that is cytokinins. Cytokinins is also a growth promoter hormone, and it promotes the cell division. It promotes the sprouting of the lateral buds, means the branches. It will delay the aging in the leaves. The leaves are remaining green for a long time because of cytokinins, and it helps in opening of stomata. So opening of stomata is a responsibility of cytokinins, and closing of stomata is responsibility of abscisic acid. So it is also a growth promoter hormone. Next is coming, that is ethylene. It is a growth inhibitor hormone. It helps in ripening of the fruit. Next is gibberellins. The germination of seeds. Okay, means it is breaking the dormancy. It helps in germination of seeds, sprouting of buds, elongation of stems, then the flower development into the fruits. Okay, these are all the functions of gibberellins. So these are the five plant hormones or phytohormones and their functions. Okay, now the next very specific characters of the plant. Which is the plant part you have observed? They are like the stem. You have seen the stem. Stem is moving always towards the sun. Okay, and the roots are moving towards the gravity. So, how does the movement take place? What is responsible for this movement? What is present in the plant which is responsible for this movement? Clear? Now the next is trophic movement. The movement of the plant which are controlled by the hormones, they are known as trophic movement. Okay, and different trophic movement are like phototrophic movement, which is also called phototropism, then geotropism, thigmotropism, hydrotropism or chemotropism. But what is the mean by trophic movement? Okay, so the movement of the plant or plant part in response to the, in the direction or opposite to the direction of stimuli. Stimuli means any changes. Here this photo means here the stimuli is light. Hydro, stimuli is water. Thigmo, the stimuli is touch. Chemo, the stimuli is chemical. And the geo means the stimuli is gravity. Understood? So in this way, the movement of the plant or plant part in the direction of or in the opposite direction of the stimulus is called trophic movement. It is also known as tropism. You can see the definition over here. When a plant exhibits some growth movement in response to a stimulus, it is referred to as a tropism. Clear? And it is also known as trophic movement. Tropism is specific to the direction of the stimulus. Either they will display a negative or positive movement. Negative movement means if they are going away from the stimulus, then it is called negative tropic movement. If it is going towards the stimulus, then it is called positive tropic movement or positive tropism. Now the first one, that is phototropism. When the plants grow towards or away from the light, as I told you, photo means light. So in the direction of the light or opposite the direction of the light, that is called phototropism. So when the plants grow towards or away from the light, the type of tropism is called phototropism. Here you are seeing the stems are moving towards the light. So the stems usually show the positive tropism. And the roots show negative tropism as they are going away from the light. Leaves are also positively respond toward the source of light. Understood? So you can see over here, this is a plant. It was straight, but when it is kept near a window, it starts moving towards the light in the direction. It is an example of phototropic movement. Now the next, that is geotropism. What is geotropism? Geo means gravity. It is gravity of the earth. So it is a type of tropism where plants show some growth in response to gravity. Clear? Means the movement of the plant or plant part towards the gravity is called geotropism. And here the stems are showing the negative geotropism, or it is also known as gravitropism, while the roots are positive to the gravitropism. Clear? You can see over here the roots are going towards the earth or the center of the earth, and the stem is going away from the gravity. It is always opposite to the gravity the stem is moving. Now the next, hydrotropism. Hydro means water. So the movement of the plant or plant parts towards the water. The movement or the growth of a plant in relation to the stimulus of water is called hydrotropic movement or hydrotropism. Clear? Here, what is the stimuli? Here the stimuli is water. And in this type of movement, the roots, obviously the roots are absorbing the water. So they are showing the positive hydrotropic response as they move and grow towards the water. This is an activity is there. Here the root is there, and this here it is growing straight. Okay, now here the for the water means the moist soil is there, and after some day if you will observe, you can see here the roots is growing, it is bending towards the moist soil where the water is present. Clear? So in this way, here around both sides the moist soil is there, but here what happened, here the dry soil, and here in a clay pot there is water is there. So this dry soil, water they are not getting, so the automatically the roots are bending towards the water. So this movement is called hydrotropism. Next is chemotropism. Now what is chemotropism? Chemo means chemical. When the plants grow in response to certain chemical, this type of response is known as chemotropism. Clear? Means the movement of the plant or plant parts toward the stimuli chemical is called chemotropism. The examples are like a flower, conversion of the flower into fruit is an example of chemotropism. You have seen here in the reproduction chapter, the pollen sit on the stigma and then develop a pollen tube. So this development of pollen tube is also one example of chemotropism. Then the movement of tentacles, and during the fertilization, this development of the pollen tube, these are all the examples of chemotropism. Clear? So chemotropism is the movement of the plant parts towards the stimuli, that is stimuli is chemical. Now the last one is there, that is thigmotropism. Thigmo means touch. The growing or developing movements made through the plants in response to the contact with a solid object are called thigmotropism. Means a simple definition, the movements of plant or plant parts towards the stimuli touch, it is called thigmotropism. you are seeing especially in the climbers that they are developing this type of structure. The weak stems are developing. When they touch any hard object, they start bending towards it. They are called tendrils. So these tendrils, okay, the development of the tendrils is an example of thigmotropism or thigmotropic movement. A fast recalling for today, what I have taught you. Today I explain you about the different hormones, the plant hormones or phytohormones, auxins, cytokines, gibberellins, abscisic acid and ethylene, which are responsible for the different functions, the growth and the development of the plant and plant parts. Then I explain you about the specific movement of the plant parts in response to the stimuli, that is called tropism or tropic movement. The different tropic movements are phototropic movement or phototropism, then hydrotropism, geotropism, thigmotropism and chemotropism. Students, I think you understood the topic. Just watch the video as it is the basic of your future study. Have a nice day ahead.